Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the TUHH CSGO tournament for the Unilan tournament. We are now playing the semi-final, BlyatBrush versus Overrated, and this is a best of three, and we're starting off on train. Right, now we see the T side of Overrated. He's pushing up towards brown holes. In fact, now rushing up towards MI has the first frag, and Arbus chimes in with the flag on A. However, Expo on the frag line, lines up three fans, two through the smoke. Arbus trades Flea, making it 2-on-1 trade, but Expo still in the smoke, shutting down. Already on the ace now. Finding all 5 kills, 4 of them with a drop Tech 9. And Ewald is getting the defuse. The counter-terrorist side is off to a good start. We do seem to have slight issues with the HUD in the client. However, we see now again an aggressive buy of the terrorist side, Overrated with Tech 9s. Pushing down into Pop Dog, but Arbus getting shut down by Expo, who went for the M4, obviously, after getting 5 frags in the last round. Gundy and DMK shut down Emmy and Z-Rope. Will they actually get the bomb plant? It looks like Expo is shutting down that as well. Mickey gets dropped. And now Hunlo's Afe on low health, the last one alive. Ewald finds him with his MP7. Good stuff from them. I see BlyatB already 2-0, 2-4-0 in the lead. Expo playing quite aggressively on the blue train, peeking both main and Pop Dog. Maybe he could face support from another one of his teammates. Now Ewald's in position, they've got the crossfire established. Overrated, however, at the moment just chilling out towards Pop Dog and Brownholds. Not really sure where they're going with it. They are on the buy, of course, after plotting in the first round. AK's on the board for most of them. And DMK could very well be the first point of contact here. It's a slower play, steadier, but Mike is slowly peeking into brown holes, whilst Emmy is setting up for a smoke, a singular smoke as it looks, as a little bit of a distraction onto the A side. That be now realizing this is actually a fake, is already on the rotate. The bomb, however, has not made its move just yet. Gandhi finds those up. Emmy trades that. DMK chimes in on Arbus. Emmy trades that one as well. It's very low. Emmy gets a third one. The trades do favor the T's. The CT's, and as I say that, Expo drops Emmy. Expo now 8-0. Frankly, there's not much that is actually in favor of the T side at the moment. Overrated. Blowing up some upgraded pistols. Going for a bit of an Ivy play. It's just one contesting right now, that's Flea. his trusty M4. Made doing solid damage onto the Ivy push. DMK already scouting for information now. Expo supporting with the rifle towards Ivy. We're actually three players up, but they can't possibly know that. DMK is still gathering info, open brown holes. If he'd push any further, he'd realize that. But Flea with three sprays him down, bombs dropped. At this point, the round is pretty much over. Expo gets one, Gandhi gets another one. And that very much eliminates their push. What opens up this round with an AWP frag on Hunlozafe. Straight out of main, already repositioning himself, shutting down the first T-side aggression. The rest of the T's, including Emmy, who is now pushing up, is still located around Pop Dog, setting up for what looks like more of a B play. However, with Mickey slowly lurking, they actually might just shift around and change their mind, go towards A. Bomb is now only being carried towards as the execute comes in, and maybe it's already dropped. Expo finds another one on Mika. Arbus trades him out finally. Flea, on the other hand, trades out Arbus. And now there's just one left alive. And he is on ladder. Zebro gets found by Gondi. In the end, quite a decisive round for that big rush. Overrated now on max loss bonus, being down 0-5. So we see a bit of a faster play towards what appears to be B. Just some upgraded pistols and some body armor on Arbus. As they can only hope to get a bomb plant down this round. Arbus is actually being tickled from Pop Dog, but doesn't do too much damage. As does this nade onto Zero. However, it shuts completely down any aggression from the T side towards the outer bomb side and actually makes them go rather inside. Of course, Expo will have heard the fire from Pop Dog, and he's in a perfect position to shut them all down. Three quick facts. Flea jumps in as well. Hunloser Alpha gets Expo in the end, but he's tagged very, very low. And there are still four CTs remaining for a Blood B rush. With his Tech 9 and low HP, he may get a free frag onto DMK, and indeed he does. But that's about all he's going to get in this round. Now Flea, thinking about chasing him. If Afe would have had the bomb, that'd be great. He could have gotten a bomb plant there. But in this instance, Ewald shuts him down. 6-0. Still with at least three people left standing. A decisive victory for Blood B. Once again, a slower paced game, or a match plan maybe by Amy, now forcing their way into Ivy, as the first two smokes land for the execute. The bomb, however, is alone in main, which could get quite critical even with the support from Pop Dog. Expo just missing Hillos after through the smoke. Flea, on the other hand, finds Arbus. It's wiped out, but Expo finds two again. Mika trades, but it's still not a favorable trade for the T side. Expo drops the carrier, Mickey through the gap, and now it's zero. Last man standing against three BlyatB players. Expo again on the flank. Another 4k for him. He is absolutely on fire. He's 18-2 at the moment. And frankly, there is no one on Overrated to stop him right now. Another very, very slow round by the T side. Zero bought up an SG, that's another rifle buff for them. And these slow runs seem to get punished quite heavily by Bliad, as Evil finds another opening onto Arbus. And Flea finds one on zero, even the Hirnloser Alpha treads back. Two of them are tagged so very low, even though they get the bomb plant here. DMK is already on your flank. Shutting down all players. Three kills in rapid succession. Another win. Frankly, at this point in time, Overrated need to get in the bot ASAP. There is nothing they can do about it. Expo once again pushed up on the blue train. Yes. Emmy punches Flea, who pop flashes himself through the smoke. Not sure if he actually spotted the bomb carrier there. But Hirnloser Alpha finds Expo on the train, even though Arbold, well, rather replies back onto Arbus with his AWP, and he has got Ivy on lockdown. Zero shuts down DMK, but two quick kills, three now for the CT side, annihilate their plant, even though it's a one-on-one situation. Ewald, with his AWP, has got the bomb dropped, facing off against Zerup with his SG. Zerup still has a minute to play with. There is no actual need to be more aggressive. Ewald swapped out his AWP smartly for an AK. Will the timing be with him? He decides now to flank around the back. Question is, will he actually turn around quick enough? He will not. Zero takes him down just by here. Retaining an AWP for his team and getting Overrated on the board. Overrated, of course, have to win this game, this round, in order to have a chance to win the game. But Expo is already shutting down Arbus. That's a big part of the IV play eliminated. Hirnloser Alpha trades back on the other side of the map, though, finding DMK. And now toys with the idea of going down Pop Dog. At the moment, it looks like BlyatB is favoring the B side. Unfortunately, that's not where the bomb is going quite yet. As a matter of fact, the Overrated team takes slowly but surely control of the A side, of the inner bomb side, as Emmy trades Ewald. And Hirnloser Alpha should hear that. They don't actually realize that's not the carrier. Now they find three kills in rapid succession. And it's all down left to Mickey. Who finds no one. Expo, of course, shutting him down. And it's been quite a desolate game so far for Overrated. Nate not actually connecting there onto anyone. They are back to the pistols, of course, after being reset so harshly by BlyatB, who have no money for days. But Overrated has managed to get themselves into brown holes so far undetected. Question is, will Gundy be able to hold off the push? DMK fans 2, DMK fans 3, Expo and Gundy clear out the rest, and that's another quite simple round for BlyatB, of course, with the inferior buy, this should not have been possible in the first place. Looks like another rather B-sided attack. They once again stack up towards Pop Dog. But Gundy pushed up quite far. He just missed the spot, but DMK already finds the first one, finds the second one again onto Mika. Is he able to get the third with this 5-7 spamming away? Does not quite connect just yet. The bomb, on the other hand, has rotated off B, of course, towards the inner bomb site. Zerup carrying it with his trusty Tac 9. Spots out Ewald. No one is able to connect critically here, as the bomb is now being carried towards Ivy. It looks a little bit headless by Overrated at this point, frankly. Fleer, of course, already staring down Ivy, knowing that that's a possible point of entry. Timing's not with him on this one. Still manages to get one. Hindler's off and trades him down. Oh, Ewald shuts him down. And he gets Arbus, last one alive. This is 11-1. Most members of BlyatB almost maxed out. Or in fact maxed out. I don't see how Overrated would come back from this, at least in this map. Luckily for them, as I mentioned before, it's a best of three. Maybe they'll get a better one in the next one. Gundy opening up in quick succession with DMK onto Hirnloser Affe. I was still willing to repeat that angle, and he actually gets the frag back onto DMK. This leaves Gundy alone in the site. They do not push behind it. In fact, Arbus is mollying off his teammate. A little bit of a miscommunication there. The Molotov to Expo, or by Expo, on the other hand, flushes out any terrorist activity in Pop Dog. Still waiting for the execute. Ewald holds the angle, actually still stacked up 3-for-1 among the sites, which is leaving B quite vulnerable. Ami now looking for an entry, but Gundy is staring hard on. Spots now just more than the barrel, actually the face of Ami, but can't connect in time. Counter rotates back on. We have Mickey already lurking inside, may have just spotted Ewald there. He does in fact take down Fleer, has apparently not spotted the second player. However, Arbus is getting a fragment. Mickey now finally realized Ewald's there. He misses an op shot. Leaves that one open. Mickey shucking on Ewald. Bomb plant's coming at 15 seconds. Timing's not with Mika on this one, however. As Expo finds Arbus. towards the connector area. Smoke denying him or the T's vision, but Zero spots him out as he approaches the train. Mikke doesn't pull the trigger on Expo even though he saw him. Sticking the defuse now, and they won't be able to reach it in time. Expo, well played, even shuts down Zero after the timer runs out. Which is, of course, terrible for him. Not quite sure why he didn't contest there. Well, well played by Expo personally. And still, the pain train continues for Overrated as they indeed make their way onto the sides once again. Okay, in hand, Zero and Hinlo Zafe push down Ivy. Bomb, however, is still located towards Pop Dog. This seems to be kind of their default play. Unfortunately, it hasn't worked out a lot in these situations. The Ivy push now comes in, but Hinlo Zafe is now spotting the head, apparently, of Fleer. Shuts him down with a quick shot of his AK. Question is, will they actually capitalize? They stacked three players on B this time, interestingly enough. Not only DMK, it's also Gandhi and the swing player who is now just going towards the other train sites, splitting the defense 2-on-2 evenly. Expo making his way out, looking once again towards Ivy as Emmy comes down Pop Dog. Spots out Expo. Does not connect critically as Expo is still on the train. Ewald takes Zero piece life, but Urbis trades Expo. Urbis now lurking in connector, has a good chance to catch DMK, but he's so low that it doesn't matter. Now 3-on-3 retake. Of course, the counter-terrorists are going to go for it. Ewald looking for a first frag, but making quite a lot of noise. However, he finds Emmy. It's tagged down a little by Mikke. But Mikke in a 1-on-2 fully blinds those. Mikke runs out of bullets, Ewald straight him. He's got another defuse as well. 13-for-1. Last round coming up. This is terrible. An absolute disaster for Overrated. The last round buys are coming up, as we see some rifles on the T side. Frankly, they could have bought any round after the 7th with the max loss bonus, of course, obtained now for the team. Expo on the AWP now has had a fantastic game so far. He's 26-5. Now aiming for the close angle off of main. The T's are pushed very far back. Haven't pushed out much, are not even into brown holes. One is stacked up around brown holes, maybe Pop Dog area. Arbus now spots two players there. This could be the signal for them to go for the 8 play, but Expo is there to greet them along with Ewald. Ewald, however, is getting shut down by Mikke now. And the swing play immediately comes in as the CTs rotate off the bomb site. On the other hand, Fleer finds Zero up. That eliminates the Ivy aggression of Overrated towards the A side. Mikke, however, pushing onward, finds Fleer. In return, Expo finds Mikke. As the T's rotate in, Expo finds another one. Nice scope onto him. Emmy finally trades him out, but she's getting lagged as well. 2-on-2 retake, but with Emmy this low, it's getting really problematic for the Overrated side. And Lozafe, on the other hand, takes down Gandhi, and now it's him in a 1-on-1. Hin Lozafe versus the last man standing, DMK. And DMK wins the duel Experiment Square, this is halftime. 14-1 is looking absolutely desolate for Overrated. Let's see if Overrated will be able to get at least one round in this half. Let's hope that they don't get mowed down as much as they got in the first half, because frankly, there's not much hope if they play like this on the second map. DMK, maybe a little bit nervous, shooting Gandhi for good luck. As the T's approach Brown Halls, with the intention of taking the B bomb site. Now there are actually only two people stacked up, which would be standard, but the question is, will they survive against the five player rush? Out, Arbis is already tagged down to 13 HP, and the T's are having full control of the site. It was quite a passive hold, and even though there is not much room gained, Mickey on the flank shuts down Ewald, but it might be too little too late. Mickey finds a second one as well, but gets shot in the face by Gandhi as Flea trades out Emmy. Arbis meets his demise in the form of a Glock as Zerop trades out Flea. Still a doable retake, 2-on-2, as Hildesoffer gets shot in the face while reloading. And Gandhi shuts down Zerop. This is 14 match points in a row for Bleb B Rush. Little to no chance of them coming back from this. Bai already coming in, of course. Two rifles, at least two SMGs, and they are of course in for the farming money. Mickey pushed up quite aggressively, walks himself into main, gets shut down by Expo, walking through the smoke like a madman. Zero is being heavily pressured by Expo, who finds now the frag, Flea as well. Now it's on the two remaining Overrated players to bring this one back. Hildesoffer finds one onto Ewald. Expo, already behind Hildesoffer, stabs him in the back. And this is GG. Gandhi meets Ami, and we go to the second map with a decisive victory of Blood B Rush over Overrated.